What's up? Merete here, and in this video, we will be looking at the muscles of the shoulders, which are a part of the upper limb. Alright, so the muscles of the upper limb are divided into four parts according to their anatomical location. The first group are the muscles of the shoulder joints, then we have the muscles of the arm, muscles of the forearm, and then we have the muscles of the hand. So again, the muscles of the shoulder joint are what we're going to focus on today. These are the deltoid muscle, subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and teres major. All of these muscles surround the shoulder joints, but the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis form the rotator cuff muscles, which allow the rotation of the humerus at the shoulder joint. They provide stability to the shoulders and prevent dislocation. These muscles are clinically important because any rotator cuff injury can cause a dull pain in the shoulders, which often worsen when you elevate the arm in a certain way. Alright, so let's talk about these muscles, and we will add the skeleton to use it as a landmark. First, we have the deltoid muscle. This is a large muscle on the shoulder that is used as an injection site in the shoulder. This muscle is divided into three parts according to their place of origin. It's divided into the spinal part, acromial part, and the clavicular part. So the spinal part originates from the spine of the scapula, as you see here. Acromial part originates from the acromium of the scapula, and the clavicular part originates from the clavicle. They all unite and insert at a common region, which is the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. The function of the deltoid muscle depend on which muscle fibers contract. For instance, if the acromial part contracts alone, it abducts the arm. If the clavicular part contracts alone, it rotates the arm internally. And if the spinal part contracts alone, it rotates the arm externally. If the spinal part and the clavicular part contract, they adduct the arm. If the acromial part and the clavicular part contract, they flex the arm. And if the acromial part and the spinal part contract, they extend the arm. So that's the magic behind the deltoid muscle. Awesome. Then we have the subscapularis. And if you look at the scapula anteriorly, here is the subscapular fossa and here is the subscapular muscle. It originates from the subscapular fossa and inserts at the lesser tubercle and the crest of the lesser tubercle on the humerus. And when this muscle contracts, it adducts the arm and internally rotates the arm. So that's this one. Now, let's look at the scapula from the posterior view. Here, we will be able to see the supraspinatus, which is this one. It originates from the supraspinous fossa, that's the fossa above the spine of the scapula, and it inserts at the greater tubercle of the humerus. And when this muscle contracts, it abducts the arm, pulling it in this direction. Then we have the infraspinatus, which is here. This one originates from the infraspinous fossa, and it inserts at the greater tubercle of the humerus. And when it contracts, it externally rotates the arm, like this. Then we have the teres minor, which is here. This muscle originates from the lateral margin of the scapula and inserts at the greater tubercle of the humerus. And when it contracts, it externally rotates the arm and also extends the arm backwards. Our last muscle is the teres major, which is here. It originates from the angle of the scapula and then it goes to the front, like you see here, and inserts at the crest of the lesser tubercle of the humerus. And so when these muscle fibers contract, they pull the arm towards the body, so adduction. They extend the arm backwards, and they internally rotate the arm. So these are the main muscles of the shoulders. Let's talk about the rotator cuff a little bit. The rotator cuff muscles are the subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and the teres minor. They stabilize the shoulder joint, as you see here. The shoulder joint is actually one of the joints in our body that endures a lot of stress all the time because you're using your arm a lot in day-to-day basis. Every time you lift something, you fall, or you just move your arms, your shoulders are involved. So these muscles stabilize the joints, and they're very important clinically because sometimes the rotator cuff muscles can undergo a rotator cuff tear, so a tear in the tendons, or an inflammation of its tendons called tendinitis. Or even the bursa of the shoulders can get inflamed, called bursitis. These are very common diagnoses to give for people with shoulder pain. Alright, so that was all the muscles of the shoulder joints. In the next video, we will be talking about the muscles of the arm.